Good evening. Today we are going to see the two checks which we have to take in design of flexural member. And we have first check that is web crippling, and second check we have web buckling. So we will see these two checks. So first we have web buckling. So according to clause number 8.7.3.1, so we have load carrying web stiffener, and this is for web buckling. And stiffener should be provided where compressive forces. So if condition is not satisfied, then we have to provide the stiffeners. And for this one, they have given cross-sectional area is taken as B1 plus N1 into TW, where we have B1 that is equal to width of stiff bearing on flange that we will see in next slide. And N1 we have dispersion of the load through the web at 45 degree to the level of half the depth of the cross section. The buckling strength of the web we have to find about parallel to axis of web. And for this one we have to use curve C to find the value of design strength. So now we can see this in this. So buckling resistance of stiffness, and that is they have given in this. So if you will read it carefully, then you are going to get this, that value of effective length, and that they mention this value of effective length that is equal to 0.7 times the length of the 0.7 times the length L of the stiffener. Here we have to consider D, that is depth of the web. So now we will see it carefully. So now two things you have to keep in mind in this. One, we have to keep in mind that angle of dispersion we have 45 degree, and where we have to go it to the level of half the depth of the cross section. So we have to find this value at the center of this cross section. And now you can see this. So web buckling, so we have, this is bearing length, we have whatever this length we have shown, this length we have bearing length. This is concentrated load, we cannot put concentrated load at a point, we have to put in a small length, and that we have uniformly load. But as it is on very small length with large value, and therefore we are saying it as concentrated load. So dispersion we have 45 degrees, and you can see for both, that is at reaction, because reaction is also a concentrated load, but that is resistance. And then we are going to get buckling, that is at center of this. Now B1 we have bearing length, and then we have this as B1 plus N1 on both sides of this. Now if we will calculate value of N1 over here, that is at center or concentrated load that is in between the supports, then we have this is B1, this is N1 by 2 we have, and this is N1 by 2. Now N1 by 2, so we are interested with this value. Now we know this, we have depth of the section D, and angle is 45 degrees. So this angle is also 45 degrees. So this distance we have D by 2, which we are going to say this distance. And so angle is 45 degrees. So N1 by 2 also you will get as D1 by 2. So this is D1 by 2, and we will get this also D1 by 2. So N1 by 2, we are going to get it as D1 by 2. And therefore N1 we will get it as D. So D1 I will not say, D we will say, that is overall depth. Whereas if we will go to the reactions, we have bearing length only on one side making angle 45 degrees. And here you will get value of N1 equal to D by 2. So B1 plus D by 2. And this also we will get D by 2. So to reactions, we have dispersion only on one side. So N1 value we will get half, that is that of intermediate one. So now if we will go L effect to 0.7 into depth of web, A is B1 into TW because parallel to web, and I is B1 TW cube by 12. And then from this, so we are going to consider this as a section, and we have this will be B1 will be, and then TW. And then we have B1 into TW. Then we have this will be about this axis. So we have B1 TW cube by 12. R is under root of I by A. And if we will put this value, then we will get B1 T with R value under root I by A. We will get TW by root 12. And then from L upon R minimum, we will get 0.7D upon TW by root 12. And FCDW that we have seen that is given B1 plus N1 into TW. This will be our bearing area and we have to multiply it by FCD. So this is my bearing area. Bearing area and we have to multiply it by FCD. And FCD we have to find from curve C. Curve C. And from this we will get value of FCD. And this FCD value we are always greater than concentrated load if we will calculate it at intermediate point and it should be greater than reaction if we will calculate it at support. So this is about your web buckling. Now if we will go to web crippling, then we have web will cripple at buckle that is at center because we have already studied the column and maximum deflection in column we will get that is at center. In the same way, your member will buckle at center. But crippling that will be at the junction of web and flange because we are going to suddenly transfer the concentrated load from larger area to the smaller area. Because if you will draw the diagram of this beam, then we have this beam in this fashion. So we have beam is like this. Now here till this we have area of flange and suddenly we are going to transfer this load on the area of web and here we may get cripple or we can say crushing of this and that crushing may occur at junction of web and flange. And what will be this distance we have to take? This will be TF plus R1 which is root of radius. If we will go to IS 808, then at that you are going to get this value of R1. And then we have B1 plus N2 TW FYW upon gamma MO. So keep in mind buckling is at center and crippling that is crushing at the junction of web and flange. Now you can see this. If you will see this clause and in that clause they have clearly mentioned that dispersion we are going to be 1:2.5 means one vertical that is equal to 2.5 horizontal and then the remaining things that is bearing length N2 length of 10 and for that area thickness of web and yield stress of web. So now we will go to this. So we can have 1:2.5. So at center again we have value that is double of that is at support. Now N2 if you will see then we have at junction. So junction means you can see we have shown that is at a root of radius. So somewhere we have here that is root of radius. So we can say this. So this point. So there we have root of radius and this root of radius we have to take B1. Sorry, we have that as TF plus R1. And then that is my root of radius. So I can say this will be somewhere here. And this value you will have TF plus R1. And then we can go with this B1 plus N2 TW FYW upon gamma MO. And FYW we have 250. So N2 we can find and N2 we will get it as 2.5 into TF plus R1. This will be at supports. And if we will find at under intermediate load, then we will get it as 2 times 2.5 TF plus R1 because we have dispersion on both sides and therefore this value becomes intermediate load. Because we have dispersion for intermediate load that is on both sides and therefore we have to take it as 2 times and then we will get value of FW. Again this value should be greater than concentrated load P or reaction. And if this satisfies, then we do not have web crippling over there. So these are about your checks. And we have actually third check, which is deflection. And that deflection shape we have, if we have concentrated load, we have WL cube upon 48 EI, and if we have UDL, then we have 5/384 WL4 upon 384 EI. So we have to go for three check. Now we will see one problem in next video for these three checks. Thank you.